first opened back in 2012. We're live inside the cavernous Marlins Park in Miami. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series between the San Francisco Giants and the Miami Marlins. Major League Baseball on the show starts now. Antonio Marquez, a Mexican-born lefty, is the man on the mound in this one. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a chance to look at a guy that's been pretty good his last three starts. A whip under 1.20, so he minimizes the amount of base runners. He's a tough customer. It'll be fun to watch him to see if he's on point early in this one here today.
Guys, you take a look at the Giants as they begin play here tonight. They've got to be considered one of, if not the hottest team in baseball right now. Winners of 8 of their last 10 ball games.
On, yeah, baby, guys, this is a dangerous team right now. Game one of a new series coming off a sweep. Everybody's feeling good. Swinging the bats red hot. This should be interesting.
Count is 1-2 now. And that one just missed outside.
Kind of pitching it backwards in this AB. Soft stuff early. Then those last two were fastballs trying to get it right by him.
The 2-2. Now here's the drive out to right center field. He's around first, heading for two. And the Marlins have something cooking. It's a leadoff double.
Hey, after that base knock right there, he's into double digits, D-Ro. That's a 10-game hitting streak.
Oh, you talking about double digits, Dan? Now it's getting firm. We're seeing the batting average go up. We're seeing the homers go up. We're seeing the RBIs go up. Everything is moving north.
Coming to the plate now, Lewis Brinson. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. Now a ball crushed high in the air, deep to left, way back there, and that one is long gone. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left, home run number 9 on the year, and the Marlins have taken a 2-0 lead.
Wow, that's what a pitcher gets for not putting what he thought was a bad call in the rearview mirror. I think he was still fuming and didn't get the pitch where he wanted it. The result?
Digging in to try it again, Buster Posey. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. The 1-1. Hit hard to third. And he whiffs on it as this ball's right under his glove. Out at the plate as they slap the tag on him. Trying to pick things up where we left off, Sean Kinsler. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
So make it two hits for him in this one as he's on base here in the home fourth. And as you have a look there at the Marlins leaderboard, you can see he currently ranks 2nd in that department. And that'll bring in the multi-dimensional Lewis Brinson. And remember, he hit that 2-run homer his first time up. The 1-0. Pitch out. Nothing doing.
Hey, let it rip one time.
Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. There's one, but they won't get two as he beats the relay to first. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Sean Kinsler. He singled his last time up.
Kinsler.
Come on, big guy, get the pitch.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And it's fouled away.
Get off me, ball. That ball's way too far inside. He's got to step out of the box right now and adjust his batting gloves because he just got stung by a pack of wasps.
This one's down to third. Throw in time at first for out number 2. Riding in once again,
Sean Kinsler. Three across so far in the inning, and another two out there on base.
Yeah, Matt, this inning's really starting to get away from them on the defensive side of the ball. Stranding the rest of those guys out here feels absolutely essential for them at this point.
All right, one time right here, kid.
Here you go now. 1-0 pitch on the way. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time.
Well, I know the last thing he wants to do is load the bases right here. So the pressure is on right now to get back in the strike zone.
Hey, let's go, big fella.
Here's a look over to first, and he just manages to get his hand in.
Come on, baby, get your pitch up there. Hey, get your pitch up there, huh?
And again a throw and a dive, but he's back in. Three runs already home here.
Hey, see it. Drive it like you can. Let's go.
And again, a throw over. And he'll dive back in.
Hey, let her rip. One time.
The 2-0 on the way. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Scooped up. And an underhanded throw is in time for out number three.
Always nice to get the first game of the series, but even more so when it's in front of the home crowd. Seems to energize everybody the rest of the series.
5-2 in the finals. MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball brings us to the great state of Florida and Marlins Park. Set to get his evening at the plate started, Sean Kinsler, batting just a notch below 300 so far on the season. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Soft liner towards center, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Hey, way to drive that one. Nice rip.
Hey, D-Row, are you aware of this? After that knock right there, that's an 11-game hitting streak. You think he knows it's at 11?
I think he knows exactly that it's at 11. It starts off innocent. You just want to get a few knocks to get the hitting coach off your back. Next thing you know, you wake up, you've been sleeping easy for almost a week, 8 days. Now we're on 11? This guy's dinner tastes different.
Oh, it's hit to third. 5 to second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Leading off the inning, Eugenio Suarez, and they'll need him to get something going here.
Eugenio Suarez.
Popped high in the air. Kinsler has a play. One down. Digging in for his second at bat, Sean Kinsler. He reached on a single in his first try.
Let's go, kid. Here we
go. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Skied into straightaway right. Rosales has a beat on it. One away. Ready once again, Sean Kinsler. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Sean Kinsler.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. In tight here with the first pitch fastball. That's 1-0. The 1-0 gets him to chase a ball out of the zone for the first strike. The 1-1 is in there for the second strike. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him.
Wow, that game flew by, but that's what happens when you get a well-pitched one-run game. Both hurlers battle, and it's almost a shame.
And we'll welcome you into our ball game as we find ourselves with the bases empty and nobody out in the inning. Ready now for the Marlins, Sean Kinsler leads off in the bottom of the fifth as they look to break through on the scoreboard for the first time in this one.
Yeah, baseball is a game of adjustments, and it's time they start making some. They don't need to change their entire approach necessarily, but now is maybe when they start thinking about ways to get the guy on the mound out of his rhythm a bit.
Tries to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's 1-1. The 1-1 home. is swung on and missed for strike number two.
Come on, Vegas, stay on.
The 1-2. Hard hit ball to second. And that's out number one.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Marlins, number 49, Ryan Ellington.
You might think it's just another win, but it's awfully hard to win in this game, especially on the road. But they find a way to get it done, and they should be very happy with this performance.
5-1, the final total in today's game. San Francisco jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Chris Stratton earns his sixth winning decision in this one. So that'll just about do it for us this afternoon. Thanks to Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. To find out more, head over to theshownation.com.
Next for me. I'm just fulfilling my destiny. Fulfilling my destiny. Yeah. I told God like what's next for me. I'm just fulfilling my destiny. I'm just fulfilling my destiny. Yeah. I told y'all I'm a psycho. Ain't no telling what I might do. Yeah. L put his hands around my throat, so I cut him off. That's what you give a stepping on my toes.
Now from the north shore of the Allegheny River, we're inside beautiful PNC Park in Pittsburgh. Tonight it's the first of four between the Miami Marlins and the Pittsburgh Pirates. Major League Baseball on the show is next. Dan Libby gets the call for game one of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a look at a guy that's really been struggling lately. In his last three starts, he has a whip of over 1.50. Lots of base runners, lots of hits, and lots of walks, and that doesn't add up to very good performances. So he's going to look to turn things around in this one here today.
Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. And they're able to get the ball in quickly, so he'll be held to a single with one away.
He wasn't letting that one go. Jumped on the first pitch right there and drove it into the outfield for a base hit.
Set to get his evening at the plate started, Orin Bailey, batting just a notch below 300 so far on the season.
Hey, get the pitch. Stay hot up there.
A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. That's lifted the other way out to left. Cortez coming in. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. With that, a look at the batting order for the Marlins. Thoughts, Dan, who stands out?
Well, Matt, I'm a bit worried about the second hitter. Over the last 10 games, he's driven in only 3 runs. That's not the kind of production you expect from a guy hitting in the middle of the order. He's had some opportunities. He just hasn't cashed in.
So here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Tyler Austin. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Here's the first pitch to him. Pitch misses the throw down. And he'll be tagged out at second base. Trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Another look at the throw down that results in a third out on the bases. Back with more on a Thursday night following this. Up next for the Buccos, Colin Moran. He appeared as a pinch hitter in yesterday's contest.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build as much as they can moving into the later innings.
And there's one down now.
All right, here's the defensive alignment for the Miami Marlins. And guys, when I've been looking at the numbers on this starting pitcher, what really jumps out on me is the fact that he doesn't strike a ton of guys out, which means he's got to execute. He's got to use those 17 inches in, out, up, and down. He's going to have his defense behind him. They better be on their toes because a lot of balls are.
Striding in, Sean Kinsler. He starts the inning, and Dan, they're down six in the early going, so what do they need to do to claw back into this thing?
Well, first of all, Matt, I think they need to start to get some base runners. It's hard to be patient when you're down by six, but base runners are the key to getting back into this one.
The pitch. Line drive to left. Cortez is there, and he makes the catch for the out.
Jumped all over that first pitch of the inning, and he didn't miss it. Just wasn't able to steer it in a direction that resulted in a leadoff hit.
Ready for another shot now. Jordan Luplo, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Runner at second here with one man out. Chopped weakly to the left. Kinsler. And there are two away now. Digging in once again, Sean Kinsler.
Third baseman, Sean Kinsler.
Hey, you got it. No one better. Let's go.
First delivery to him on the way. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. But this is foul for the first strike.
All right, all you're asking for as an offense is a chance. Well, your leadoff man has certainly done his part. He's gotten on base. You have to start clawing back into this game right now if you're going to find a way.
Outside for a ball, 1-1.
Yeah, see it, drive it. Let's go, big dog.
Down low, two balls and a strike.
Oh, baby, get your pitch up there.
The 2-1. Liner toward right center, and that's in for his second hit of the afternoon. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Hey, there's a base hit right there. Now they have a couple of runners on with less than two outs, but they're down by so much in this game that hopefully maybe they can get something started here in this inning.
Yeah, 100%, Dan. I've played the game a long time. I've never seen a big league hitter give an at bat away. You chip away and fight until that 27th out is made.
Oren Bailey.
The 1-2. To first. Bell picks it up. On to second, but it's a wide throw, and the shortstop can't recover. And he'll come in to score from second base, and that is a direct result, obviously, of that poor throw.
Well, it's really hard to complain about this one because that's one of the hardest double plays to turn. The first baseman has to deal with the runner headed to second, and he sometimes shields you from throwing where you want to make the throw. They should have made it, but that's a tough play all the way around.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Tyler Austin. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Spin and a throw back to second. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. Weak grounder back to the mound. He'll throw back to second to get the out, and that's going to be all they get. Boy, a risky play there, but it pays off. Ready for another chance? Dave Britt. And he's got runners at the corners here with only one gun. One run, five hits, and one error so far for the Marlins. And he misses with it, ball four, so that'll load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball.
That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk him to load the bases. Now he's really got his work cut out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
Come on, baby, get your pitch up there.
Here now the 2-2. Takes this the other way to right. That's in there. Base hit. And the runner from third scores as they try to work their way back into this one. So striding forward now, Sean Kinsler. He singled his last time up.
Kinsler.
First pitch of the at bat. There's a strike.
0 balls, 1 strike.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Luplo is right there. Two gone. Up next from Miami, Sean Kinsler, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. No balls and one strike.
Hey, right guy, right spot. No one better up there.
Here's the 0-1. There's a ball into right center field. That's going to be a base hit. And to score, the runner from second.
You know, D-Ro, in today's game, it's not easy scoring in the late innings. So that RBI base hit to tie things up, that comes at a really good time.
Yeah, I say it's not easy. They got 11 guys in the bullpen, and I don't think a guy throws under 97 miles an hour with sinking cut. That is unbelievable he's able to get that knock in that big spot.
The left fielder, number 30.
Stepping in, Orin Bailey. These two have not faced each other at the major league level. For the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. And a dive, but he's back in there. Hit in the air to straightaway center. Frazier over to his left. And they did some damage offensively in this one, enough to get the win, and this man led the charge. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he certainly was a big part of this victory. Picked up 4 RBIs in the game, so it's safe to say that he came through when they needed him to.
9-7, the final score in this ball game. The Pirates came through when it mattered in the night. From one of the best ballparks you'll find in the... Jameson Taillon gets the start for Pittsburgh in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
This guy's a pretty good pitcher, and I was looking through the stats, and one thing jumped out at me, a sub 1.20 whip coming into this start. That tells me a couple of things. One, he's not afraid to throw strikes, and two, when he does throw strikes, he throws quality, and he still gets people out. It'll be fun to watch this guy work in this one today.
The throw into second. And he's out trying to stretch it into a double, so a costly mistake here leading off the inning.
Take a look at the Pittsburgh Pirates defensive lineup. And let's take a look at Starling Marte, another one of those super athletic outfielders of the new regime. Ability to cover ground, can play multiple positions in the outfield, hit in the middle of the order.
So here now is the pitcher, Stephen Brault, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield.
Guys.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch. Popped high in the air. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Pirates strand a couple. Now at the plate, Sean Kinsler.
Third baseman, Sean Kinsler.
Yeah, we need you right here. One time.
First pitch on its way. Sent on the ground out to second. There is Escobar. And very quickly there, they're two gone to start the inning. Jacob Stallings will be the next hitter.
Now batting, catcher, Jacob Stallings.
And a ground ball to third. Kinsler is there. And that's the second out.
Here we go.
So striding in, Sean Kinsler, a hit in two
Sean
tries so far.
Kinsler.
First offering on its way. Softly on a line to third, but gloved by the third baseman for the out.
Right guy, right
now
place.
To the plate, Sean Kinsler, runner in scoring position. With
Sean
Tugan.
Kinsler.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Ball one.
Right, 1-0.
Hey, drive him in. Need you right here.
1-0 pitch on the way. And a breaking ball stays outside.
Do you take your chances in this situation as a hitter, knowing he's just missed outside two pitches in a row, and dive a little bit and try and drive something in the opposite field?
Fouled away.
Come on, big, get your pitch. Let's go.
Popped up. Bell is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble. So no runs on no hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. It's the Marlins 2 and the Pirates 1. And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ball game. The Marlins came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Johnny Knapp earns his third win of the year in relief. Drew Storen closes the door for the save, his 26th. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa.